I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you, no other will do. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
Now, the Fed was aware that it would almost certainly produce a recession. And Volcker says, I'm going to stick with my policy. Even though the recession that begins in 1981 was the longest recession in post-war history. In that period of a couple of years, the world's view, the political view of the role of the Federal Reserve and its importance in the country changed dramatically. And I don't believe it would have been possible without a man of Paul Volcker's stature.
Paul Volcker has advised me of his decision not to accept a third term as a member and chairman of the Federal Reserve Board.
With inflation tamed, Volcker was expendable. President Reagan would not reappoint him to a third term. But Volcker had restored faith in the dollar and in our central bank. And he'd laid the foundation for an era of unprecedented prosperity. It would be up to the next chairman to keep it alive.
In the years following the Second World War, it was easy, for a while at least, to overlook the price tag. Our income more than doubled in the 25 years after the war. We increased our take-home pay in those 25 years by more than we had amassed in all the preceding 150 years put together. Yes, there was some inflation, 1 or 1.5% a year. That didn't bother us. But if we look back at those golden years, we recall that even then, voices had been raised warning that inflation, like radioactivity, was cumulative and that once started, it could get out of control.
When the core of inflation is functionally higher than any time it's been published since 1983, how old were you in 1983? Do you remember the level of misery? Congratulations. This is what the policies around this place did. And if you get a clown that's trying to say, oh, it's Ukraine, it's this and that. No, it's not. This stuff was in the futures market long before.
As former Chairman Paul Volcker put it, at the height of the great inflation in 1979, inflation feeds in part on itself. So part of the job of returning to a more stable and more productive economy must be to break the grip of inflationary expectations. While higher interest rates, slower growth, and softer labor market conditions will bring down inflation, they will also bring some pain to households and businesses.
Do you agree with the perspective, and then I'll be done, but do you agree with the perspective that if interest rates go too high too fast, it could drive us into a recession?
It's certainly a possibility.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't gonna do.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same,
I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on just want to start a flame in your heart.